Hello students, now let's start the lesson. The boy who sold wisdom. I'll read the textbook. Nagendra was orphaned and found himself without a job. He was clever and he had learned many things by observing his father. So Nagendra was an orphan. So orphan means, you know, without parents. He had lost his parents long back. So he found himself without a job. He had been jobless for some time. He was clever and he had learned many things by observing his father. He was very clever and intelligent. And he had learned many things by his father, by observing his father. One day he had a brilliant idea. Now he went into town and hired the smallest and cheapest place he could find and set up a shop. Now he was jobless, so he wanted to earn something for his living. So he had a brilliant idea. What was the idea? He went into town. He wanted to set up a shop. To set up a shop, he had to get so many things, right? He went into town and hired the smallest and cheapest place he could find and set up a shop. He spent a few nickel coins he had on paper, ink and a pen. So he had to buy so many things. Only with the whatever left out money, he just bought a paper, ink and a pen. He spent only a few nickel coins he had, so to set up a shop. Now over his shop he put a placard that said wisdom for sale. So what is a placard? A handwritten notice to display for the public. So he just displayed a placard saying that wisdom for sale. So the name he gave for that is wisdom for sale. All around him were merchants who had large shops. Yes, now all around him there were so many shops selling so many things. They sold cloth, jewelry, fruits, vegetables and things that people bought every day. It was a marketplace. They sold all the things like cloth, jewelry, fruits, vegetables and so many more. But Nagendra, what did he sell? What did he sell? He sold wisdom. Nagendra called out, all kinds of wisdom for sale, reasonable prices. He was hawking. The hawkers, they'll shout at about the goods they want to sell. Right, all kinds of wisdom for sale, reasonable prices. So he was shouting at the people. The people who had come to buy things could not see anything in his shop. So, but could only hear the words he was shouting. So they were surprised to see nothing in his shop. Even then he was shouting at all kinds of wisdom. Couldn't only hear the words he was shouting. They crowded around and laughed at him. They laughed at him, thinking that he was a fool, stupid. No one bought even one piece of wisdom from him. But he was patient. He didn't lose his patience. Now, one day, Babu, a rich merchant's son, happened to pass by and heard the wisdom seller hawking his wares. Now one day Babu, the rich merchant's son, happened to pass by and heard the wisdom. He just passed by Nagendra's shop. Now he was surprised to see that here that he was selling wisdom. Wisdom, wisdom of all kinds, he was shouting at. He was a stupid boy. Babu, the rich merchant's son, he was a stupid boy. What did he think? He didn't know what was really being sold. He thought it was a vegetable or a thing he could hold in his hand. So he asked Nagendra what it would cost per kg. Nagendra said, I do not sell wisdom by weight. I sell it by quality. Now he was a stupid boy, Babu, the rich merchant's son. He thought that wisdom was something that he could hold by in his hand. So he asked Nagendra how much it would cost, how much the wisdom would cost per kg. Nagendra said, I do not sell wisdom by weight. I sell it by quality. It's not measured in quantity. So I sell it by quality, Nagendra says. Now let's end up the session here. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you.